win, the winner is still Matthew Tillman. Who needs this one? Boy, I don't think I missed any of them, but I
could get them. Boston crunched them all, and now has a shot at the $10,000 sweepstakes fair.
For Earl Anthony not to be just too much of a 5-10 and needed to slide it over into the 10-10 to have a chance to win the match. Brian Voss coming up with a chance to make the 5-7 split and register a perfect score of 300, making all five scores in his first attempt and make that score. Since I remember watching the show in the 50s, I don't recall many players ever making all five of them. Voss has a chance.
So it's 150-50. Ron Voss will move on to meet Leatherway Williams Cross, who has a shot at the sweepstakes. Voss over Anthony. Anthony will pick up a check for $5,000. And here it is, though, the sweepstakes fair. It's a copy, the 4-7-9-10.
Ryan Voss already $10,000 in his pocket. Due to the victory over Earl Anthony, needs to get the ball over to the left side of the four pin drive, the four into the 9-10 zone, pick up an extra $20,000.
There you go. 1 cent. Nope. 4 out of 5 missing on the sweep stage, but he's $10,000 richer and the opportunity to go. Made his in the first match,
okay. 50-point value on this 4-5 as you see Walter A. Williams' ball go right between the 4 and 5 pins. But you know there's a tremendous advantage, it looks like, at just being ahead of the match. Players, I don't realize or don't even think that the last pair of equalizers is the key pair. So you just have to stay close. Ryan Voss didn't put too much pressure on himself. Obviously trying to make it. Don't worry about that last shot.
Dropping the 4 off the 5, so he now trails 100-50.
The ball just goes to the left of the 5-10, taking the 4 straight back. But it's really not disaster for Brian Voss. He takes the 4-pin out. He still has a 50-pin. It trails by 50 pins, but there's two really tough shots left. The match is still up for grabs.
Certainly is, and we'll be back for the climactic close to the second match.
He's in good shape. The ball will take out the 2 and into the 7, but the head pin just gets flying around the 10. Not to be. And the score sits right now as Brian Voss having just 50 points through 4 frames. Walter A. Williams Jr. perfect with 150, but the man who makes the equalizer a 5-7 score still has a chance to win.
The equalizer at the name, frame 5. 150 points.
Possible perfect score for Walloway Williams Jr.
He has done it. With that 5-7 conversion, Walloway Williams has clinched the second match, winning over Brian Voss. $10,000 and a shot at the sweepstakes fair with $20,000.
Boy, there's never a doubt. When it left his hand, we're sitting in the announcer, we see that ball is in perfect position. It's breaking in about the 13th, 40, yep, the 5-10, the 0-7. He has a perfect game. Here's Voss, a shot out.
So, Walter A. Williams, $10,000 plus the opportunity to shoot the sweepstakes there worth $20,000.
The value, $20,000, 4-7-9-10 sweepstakes there. Chris, I'm sure he's going to give it a great run. He really made those scores very easily and a perfect score. His first round, 300. Ryan comes up, needs to slide the 4-pin over into the 9-pin. The ball will take out the 7. $20,000 at stake. He cleans his ball to a fifth ball. He's taking a real.
No. So that sweepstakes ball, very tough to come by. That one was worth $20,000 on one shot. So it's $10,000 for the man on the left, Walter A. Williams Jr., $5,000 in the second. But remember, Voss won $10,000 in victory over Earl Anthony.
Here's the shot of Walter A. Williams Jr. He attempts to make the sweepstakes score just flies by the 4-10, knocking off the 7-6. I think he made a bad move by changing balls. But then again, that's always hindsight is always the best side sometimes.
There's the margin of victory, 300 to 50, $10,000 for Williams, $5 for Voss. A total of 30,000 here today by the three professionals. Brian Voss, 15,000. Walter Ray Williams Jr., 10,000. And Earl Anthony with $5,000. Here's the man that was on the entire show. Frank Tacoma. Congratulations.
Thanks. It's certainly advantageous to be in the first match. You want to make the most money, especially if you win the first match. So thanks for that.
Do you attack the stairs a lot?
I get enough practice on tour. My gosh, you look like never enough. So I get enough on tour.
Okay. Nice going, Brian. We always enjoy watching you bowl. Nelson is with two that we also have a great deal of respect for, Bo.
First, the all-time player on PBA Tour, Earl Anthony. Earl, he started off with two stairs and got a little shaky. Anything go wrong in the middle of the match? Not really. I was really lined up well for the stairs, Bo. I just lost it. I just made bad shots. First time in my life I've ever done that. It makes a difference if you're on tour and it's crazy. Hey, and the man who made all five stairs, Walter Ray, you changed balls for the two straight stairs. Will that make a difference, or if you had it back, would you do it again?
It does make a little difference. My strategy is to try and get to that big stair, and I had a good shot for the first five. I never did hit that strike part stair in the practice session, so I don't know if it's going really well.
All right, good luck the next time, Cliff. You have the win. Thank you, guys, and thank you, Bo. We invite you to stay tuned for the Professional Bowling Tour. It's the $270,000 Just for PBA National Championship. Not even the 60.